support
okay.
this budget. Thank you, sir.
Sri Bajain Banda.
Sir, as I rise to speak on the government's supplementary demand for grants, this August House must consider the context in which these demands are made. Sir, the Honourable Finance Minister has been widely acclaimed in the past for his handling of the Indian economy. But the situation in which he has recently taken charge of this portfolio again is quite different, sir. He has inherited a situation which is very different from his last stint. Rather than being feted and boasted about, this is an economy that is ailing. We can have people say that 5% growth rate is still very high in the world, but that's not true, sir. 5% is not high considering a country of India's size and level of development, which is still aspiring to really become a middle-income country. Let us look at the impact that the current fiscal situation has on the Aam Aadmi, which this government claims to represent so much. Look at the inflation figures, sir. Sir, we are almost touching double-digit inflation when you look at the consumer price index. The numbers have been discussed, but some inaccurate numbers have been stated. Let me cite the numbers as recently reported in a major national daily that this month's November's report, which has just come out, inflation is at 9.9%, which is knocking on the doors of double-digit inflation. If you look at what was the case in September and October, it was 9.73% and 9.75%, which means the trend is that it is worsening. Steadily but gradually, the trend is worsening. If you look at the items that particularly impact the average citizen, look at consumables like oils and fats, sir, which every household requires for cooking. In November, it has grown on an annualized basis of 17.67%. It is totally beyond the means of the Aam Aadmi. If you look at sugar, 16.97%. If you look at pulses, 14.19%. Vegetables, 14.74%. And for non-vegetarians, it is not very much better, sir. Meat, fish, eggs has risen by 11.33%. Sir, if you look at the rural versus urban, rural Indians are suffering even more. While urban inflation, consumer price index was 9.69% in November, rural was 9.97%. It is almost touching double digits, sir. Sir, in this context, when the government asks this August House to approve demands of a further 32,100 odd crores, out of which they will only bring about savings of 1,314 odd crores. That means a net cash outgo of more than 30,800 crores. We must look at some of these items. Because of limited time, sir, I want to highlight only one or two issues. The Air India issue has been talked about some people. I want to put a different perspective on it, sir. Sir, we know the civil aviation industry is going through a bad time, not just in India, but throughout. But even within that bad industry, you can distinguish which are the airlines that are genuinely trying to make a difference and which is not. Sir, the 2,000 crores that this government proposes that we approve for further infusion into Air India comes on top of the following. In 2009-10, 800 crores. In 2010-11, 1,200 crores. In 2011-12, another 1,200 crores. And already this year in the budget in 2012-13, 4,000 crores. And now yet again another 2,000 crores. So how long will this go on? This is a bottomless pit and it doesn't seem to have any end point. I don't think it will be wrong to describe this truly as a Maharaja's ransom. Sir, I just wish to illustrate with an anecdote the kind of difficulties passengers are facing, consumers are facing. Just 2 days ago, one East Asian airline have been negotiating for wages and their staff have announced a strike. Their version of a strike, sir, is a no-smile strike. Their staff is threatening that they will stop smiling. Sir, I would venture to say that in India, even if such a strike were announced, I don't think passengers could tell the difference from normal times. Sir, Air India's functioning has been criticized by constitutional bodies such as the Committee for Public Undertakings. It has been criticized by the CAG. This is a whole other matter. I don't want to go into the details. But for the government to simply come and ask us for 2,000 crores as if it is petty change, without actually putting forward a game plan for rehabilitating Air India, is not the right approach, sir. Sir, even in this economic condition, there are airlines which are doing well. IndiGo Airlines is running efficiently and running a profit. Sir, for somebody from Odisha, for somebody who's in the opposition but wishes to take a rational approach to the government's demand, you're not making it easy, sir. Sir, very recently, Air India has withdrawn flights from Bhubaneswar to Kolkata and to Chennai. Sir, the plan to convert Bhubaneswar into an international airport has been dragging, the government has been dragging its feet for years now. Sir, the new airport terminal, which is under construction, has missed several deadlines and is today lying stalled. Construction is not going on. This government does not make it easy for us to approve this kind of expenditure, sir. Give us a rational game plan. Show us that you intend to do the right thing by us. It will make it easier for us to support these kind of things. Sir, Air India is only one aspect. Let me point out, if you look at the petroleum sector, sir, this government is not only not doing the right thing, sir, I venture to say that it does not treat this house with respect in proposing these numbers to us. And let me point this out, sir. Sir, the oil marketing companies have an under recovery of more than 28,000 crores. 28,000 crores as compensation for under recoveries is proposed. Another 500 crores to incentivize states for cash transfers for PDS kerosene. Sir, I want to point something out here, sir. Sir, in this year's budget, 12-13, only 40,000 crores was budgeted under this head by this government. Despite the fact, if you look at the track record of the past few years, our actual subsidy on this account has always been high. So there was really never any question that the government could manage with only 40,000 crores. And therefore, it has now come in with this extra. If you look at last year, sir, if you look at 2011-12, the budget was, the subsidy was 65,000 crores. So one can only draw the conclusion that despite having 65,000 crores in 11-12, if you are now proposing only 40,000 crores this year, it was done only with an intention to window dress the budget to show the budget, the deficit to be less, which was never actually going to pan out. And that is exactly what we are seeing now, to have a very radically increased subsidy for this. So diesel subsidies, which were only 2,100 crores in 2004-05, have gone up to 81,000 crores in 2011-12. So there is a lot of distortions that is happening. We all know what has happened to diesel, and the approach that the government has been taking has been piecemeal, sir. Now, recently, an effort has been done to put an extra cess on diesel passenger cars. So there have to be a more comprehensive, more holistic approach to deal with this, not piecemeal and not taking an approach of one quarter or two quarters at a time, but to come up with a proper solution. But I know time is of essence. I will just come to a conclusion. I want to point it out, sir, that there are so many things that we have been demanding. If the government had been seriously taking some of our demands, it would make things much easier for us to cooperate and support these kind of budgetary provisions. In Odisha, sir, we have been asking for upgradation of 3 medical centers to AIMS-like institutions under the PMSSY, Pradhan Mantri Swasthya Suraksha Yojana. This has not been taken up. So we have a desperate shortage of doctors in the state. In my own constituency in Kendrapada and throughout the state of Odisha, we have a 50% shortage of doctors. It is impossible to get enough doctors to go to rural areas. We need more medical colleges. We want to raise the number of seats for admission into MBBS courses from 150 to 250 in the 3 medical colleges. In agriculture, there's a proposal to set up a central agriculture university to serve the needs of Odisha, particularly the KBK districts, about which, from the time of Prime Minister Rajiv Gandhi, so many crocodile tears have flowed down the Mahanadi.
Okay, all right.
Sir, just half a minute more, sir. Sir, projects relating to flood management are pending, large numbers of them, without getting attention from this government. And the railways, the less said is less said, the better. We have unmanned crossings that endanger lives. We have projects that have been going on for 32 years, sir. And we have one of the lowest density of rail track to either geography or to population. I urge the government to keep these demands in mind, to take some concrete steps to make it easier for us to support such budgetary demands. Okay.